Hey guys, welcome back to Dion Seeing Some More. Today we're going to be doing a repair on my carbon cub.
More like a complete rebuild.
Yes. Yeah.
Tell them what happened. Who did it?
So, we were flying and my dad asked to take over the controls and I said, yeah. He tried doing an inverted backflip. He was not high enough and completely just put it nose down into the ground.
Yep. So, what did we learn?
Intermediate only.
Yeah.
Intermediate and beginner only.
And or get high enough in the air if you're going to try tricks.
Yeah.
All right.
Oof.
Let's start.
So now the first thing we're going to do is remove the wings. And before we even try to move the up here, we're going to remove the little staffs. I can't remember what they're called.
I think they're called, I don't know either.
Wing stabilizers or struts, whatever.
That has to come off.
All right, now on to remove the screws on the struts. Wow, look at the damage on here. The battery exploded out when we crashed too.
Yeah, it did. It crunched it. All right, flip it, get that wing off.
Okay, now these four screws right here. And let's unscrew them. All right, now once you've gotten those four screws off, you're gonna wanna remove this part and leave the screws in them because otherwise you're gonna lose them. Okay, so now we've gotten the wings off and we found more damage actually, and we're gonna glue this back on and just reuse it.
Yep.
All right, now we're gonna glue this in and we're gonna avoid this little staff so that way we don't get that stuck.
And by the way, the glue we're using is foam, or felt and foam tacky glue. I've used all those RSC hobby glues, but the best glue I found is this white stuff, and it's found at any hobby store that, you know, sells fake flowers that are gonna push into styrofoam.
Real quick, the little staff.
It doesn't move here, let me see. Just like that.
Yep.
All right, let go. Grab a napkin.
All right, now once you've gotten all this off, we're gonna remove the LED evil eye, and you're gonna wanna be very, very careful with this. All right, now we've got it removed, and look at the insides. Everything is perfectly good. It's safe, and the GPS is good to reuse. All right, now we're gonna remove all the clevers from the elevator and rudder. Let me just slide this down. All right, now you're gonna remove these screws so that way we can take off the rudder and the elevator. And just like so, it slides right out. All right, now we're gonna remove the landing gears. And it's gonna be these four screws holding it on. All right, now we're gonna take off the wheels once we've gotten these screws off that holds it on. And it's off. Okay, now after we've done all this, we're gonna take the prop off. Okay, after you've taken off the prop, we're gonna remove all three of the screws to the cowl and we just lift up like so. All right, now we're gonna remove the GPS model and then all the internal parts. All right, this is out. And now for the internal parts.
Looks good, put it up.
All right, so now what we just did is we labeled every single servo to each channel so we don't get it wrong and just start guessing. Okay, now we're gonna remove this tiny little screw on top of the servo arm. And after you've done that, we're gonna remove the... We will remove the servo arm. Pry it off. All right, so how we got these servos out was we had removed the tail end and we just started prying everything out with a flathead. And that's removed. Right, now after removing the servos, we're gonna remove the flight receiver. we're gonna pry it up with the screwdriver, and it just comes right out. All right, now we're gonna remove the motor with these four screws right around here. All right, so we got the motor in, but before we did that, we just fed the ESC through on the little patch through here. We just fed it through. I just pulled
a little bit. Okay, tighten the last screw.
And now we tighten the last screw. All right, now we're gonna put the flight receiver back into its little compartment. We're gonna remove this little bit of tape. And we are going to stick it back in there.
There you go, drop it in.
You see? Okay, you just gotta push it in there. Just give it a little pressure.
Yep, that's it. Just a little pressure.
Oh my goodness, I thought I was gonna mess it up. Oh.
Oh, you did good.
Recording?
Yeah.
All right, now we're gonna reattach the LED Evil Eye.
Yes.
And we're going to just ever so carefully just... All right, after we put it in the servos, we're gonna reattach the rods to the servo arms and put the servo arms back on to the servos. And now we're gonna tighten them down until it stops. All right, now we're gonna reattach the elevator and the rudder. And all right, now we're gonna put the landing gears back on, slide that in. And then we're gonna put the little screw holder on. This way is the right way, right? Nope. Okay, now we're gonna put the cowl back on. And let's get this on. Stick that screw in. And okay.
There you go.
Alright, so now we put on a new blade. We got the cowl back on. And now we're gonna get the nose.
Yeah, I think there's a prop nose cap. I don't know.
Yeah, I think it's the nose cap, yeah.
Yeah, sure, nose cap.
All right, now we're gonna put on the hatch. And you will notice that these two little entries, these two little entry holes that you will squeeze it in. All right, now what we just did was we just reapplied the wings. And now we're gonna tighten all these. All right, now we're gonna get these on. I can't remember their names.
Wing support, don't know either, but that's the good thing about the hobby. All right, so tell the camera what we're doing.
All right, now we're just having that little moment of truth to see if everything works. And by the looks of it, we gotta trim the rudder a little bit by the servo, not by the controller.
Okay.